This video will demonstrate the microsurgical resection of an inferior medullary cavernous malformation. The patient was in his early 20s. He presented with intermittent bilateral foot paresthesias and pain, and also bilateral tongue fasciculations and myotonia. MR imaging showed a cavernous malformation on the posterior aspect of the medulla just below the obex. Here are the MR findings. On the left, you can see a T2 weighted axial cut with the malformation coming to the surface in the posterior midline. The sagittal view on the right shows the relationship of this malformation to the tonsil and the obex. The patient was positioned prone and a simple midline incision was made with a small or mini suboccipital craniotomy and C1 laminectomy. Surgical strategy consisted of this small suboccipital craniotomy, a small peel incision, entrance into the cavernous malformation, evacuation of clot from within, establishment of a plane around the capsule, piecemeal removal, and finally, removal of additional blebs of the malformation. Here is an overview of this mini suboccipital craniotomy. You can see that a simple midline incision here is all that is needed, and this gives nice views into the gutters just below the tonsil. Here we see the dentate ligaments and the contributions to the accessory nerve. And here on the other side, a nice view of the vertebral artery. Here the posterior median sulcus is being opened by incising the pia overlying it. You can see that the underlying malformation has poked its way to the pial surface just below this midline vein and just below the pia. Here the incision is being extended inferiorly, and now with a little sharp dissection, we enter the malformation and drain some blood. This drainage of blood is meant to collapse the malformation, to take out whatever fluid is within it, and to gain some space between the malformation and the capsule. Here are these nice, delicate round knives, which sharply develop this plane of dissection between the capsule and the adjacent gliotic tissue. We go from one side to the other, we go from top to bottom, and slowly we work this plane open between the malformation and the adjacent tissues. From where we're located, you can see that we are adjacent to the gracilis and cuneate nuclei, and so our dissection needs to be particularly gentle. By working inside the lesion at the beginning, we can help to develop these planes and not get into that really sensitive border. This lesion was a little bit more adherent than expected. You can see that I'm using a little gentle traction to help identify where these points of adhesion are located. And here, finally, I can break into that plane and separate the capsule from the adjacent gliotic margin. Still, there are some dense adhesions here that are holding the malformation in inferiorly. So with some additional work, I can get around those points of adhesion and start to free this thing up. I like to take these out en bloc, but as you can see with this case, this needed to come out piecemeal. And also what you'll see is that as the resection nears its end, there still are a lot of these little blebs of malformation, almost like the little drupelets of the berry that have been shed from the berry itself. And you can see these little spots in the gliotic margin. These are like the seeds that require some meticulous removal. Here's our overview at the end. You see preservation of that overlying vein. You can see our safe entry through the posterior median sulcus and our mini exposure. The patient tolerated this procedure well. He was discharged home on postoperative day 3. His postoperative MR imaging demonstrated complete removal of the malformation. In conclusion, these posterior inferior medullary cavernous malformations can be exposed with a mini suboccipital craniotomy with C1 laminectomy. The posterior median sulcus is one of our safe entry zones for this particular malformation. The proximity to sensory nuclei requires delicate dissection in removing these malformations. Thank you.